Hello everyone and welcome to another podcast episode on M&D Fantasy Corner. I'm Duncan and with me, as always, is my friend over here, Momo.
Hello everybody. I think this was perfect opportunity for you to change intro, man, and you fail. Because this will not be a podcast episode, basically. This episode, guys, we are doing something new. I watched that TV show Witcher on Netflix. And man, I liked it so much that, you know, I made Duncan watch it too. And, you know, we decided to do a review from our points of view of, you know, what we think about this TV show.
You know what I think will be the weirdest part?
What?
So far on our channel, we only do Stormlight and we do Malazan. So we have kind of already established community. But this episode is prone to bring some new people. And they are going to be like, who the fuck are these two dudes? What the fuck are they saying?
Probably. And they will probably ask, why is this guy recording in pajama? Because as you guys can see, you know, Duncan got t-shirt and everything. And look at me. I swear this is my pajama.
I'm wondering, what are you doing? Why?
Man, you know, I was too comfortable to fucking change. So sorry, guys.
Okay, so but let's go back to Witcher. Do you want to start?
I really want to start, man, because I was skeptical, I will say. I'm generally skeptical because, you know, fans of fantasy genre are... I think we learned in past that, you know, to not expect anything, basically, from these adaptations. Only successful, basically, adaptations that we had of fantasy world on, you know, in TV show or in movies, in my opinion, where Middle Earth, and that is Lord of the Rings and Game of Thrones, except, you know, last season. But, you know, they were successes and they were, in my opinion, good adaptations. Other than that, pretty much everything, in my opinion, was one kind of or other kind of shit, basically.
Okay,
but... Maybe I'm missing something. So I was very worried, man, about... I was excited, but also worried, especially because we are getting Witcher. Very soon we are getting Wheel of Time. And in my opinion, these two TV shows are very important, not only for fans of Witcher and Wheel of Time, but fans of general, you know, fantasy, fans of Malazan, fans of Stormlight, because if these two shows do good, this will probably mean, man, that more and more fantasy will get, you know, adaptation on big screen or small screen or whatever. And I will tell you honestly, man, when after I watched two episodes, I was kinda, you know, I was not satisfied. Because after I watched two episodes, like, I didn't like too much show. And another problem that I had, and that was not problem about TV show, that was my problem. Because I didn't read books before. I play a game. And I thought that they made too many changes. And I was pissed about it. Until I read in comments on some YouTube video, I forgot, that they are actually very faithful to books. That they are not following games. And after that, I started reading book, and I'm already on book two, and I can tell you that, you know, they did really, really a good job of adapting it. And after I finished, like, those two first episodes, I was kind of, like, you know, I wasn't very satisfied. I enjoyed fight scenes, but, you know, I didn't feel some connection to characters and anything else, basically. But, man, the more I watched, I swear, the more I liked it. And at episode 10, I really wanted to see more. I really fucking need more Witcher now, man.
Okay, so this is where, like, we are gonna have such a different opinion on this. It's crazy. So you really liked the show?
Yeah, I think they did a good job, man. Especially after I read books, because I think it's very hard to adapt this first and maybe even second book, because they are not cohesive book, man. They are like exactly like how TV show was. They are like some stories about Witcher that are disjointed. They are jumping, you know, in various timelines, basically. And they somehow made it, in my opinion, a little bit cohesive. A little bit more cohesive than in books, for a matter of fact.
Okay, so I would just want to say, for example, did you play Witcher 3?
No, but I my computer couldn't take it, but I watched videos of people playing it. So I know what's happening in Witcher 3, basically.
So to me, I'm kind of same. I played Witcher 1, I played Witcher 2, and like those games, to me, I have good memories with them, but I wasn't blown away. Like, if I could score them on a scale 1 to 10, I would give them like 7. I could never understand the obsession with that game. Like, what is the... I want to take somebody who is huge fan of Witcher, add it to this show, and I want them to tell me what's so special about... For example, I'm just talking about games. What is so special about Witcher games? Why do they deserve such a high score?
Just to interject 1 second, man, because I kind of agree with you there, and I kind of disagree. Because I'm a huge fan of RPG genre. And I played a lot of them. And I could never enjoy... I finished first and second Witcher. And I swear to you, man, I finished it more out of obligation to RPG genre than out of actual enjoyment. But I get it why they think it's one of the greatest RPG games ever made. Because it is great. It just somehow, for some reason, it's not my style, man.
But why?
I don't know if this makes sense.
What?
I'm ahead because it's great story, great characters, great plot, great romance, great everything. It has, you know, if I had to choose everything that RPG has, I swear to you it would be Witcher. But when I play it, I don't enjoy it, like, at all, almost.
So, I already disagree in one thing, that it has great story. I just don't see it. And this same, that problem, to me at least, I watched full show, by the way, it translated into the show, the same issue, the same problem. I just didn't see it. Like, what is so great about that story?
Man, this is beginning of the story. You cannot... What was so great about, I don't know, first season of Game of Thrones story? There was nothing there. This is just, you know, introduction.
To me, those two are not even comparable in story.
I agree.
Like, when I read Game of Thrones, that book hooked me so badly. Like, I wanted to read more and I wanted to read it right now. That was my reaction. After watching Witcher, at least for me, I don't really care about that story, because to me it's a little bit silly. It's...
You know what also might be a problem, man?
What?
Because you kinda know what will happen.
I don't know. I have no idea what will happen.
I mean, you know, from the games.
I don't even remember. Like, I know that he goes through those adventures. I remember that elves have some issues. There are some kingdoms. There are some kings. But, like, the story never hooked me to...
So you really didn't like the TV show?
I mean, show was okay. Like, again, I can... If I would give it a score on a scale of 1 to 10, I'd give it 7. Same like games. It's like, I'd watch it. I'm not gonna be bored.
Yeah, but you are... Okay, yeah, I understand.
But I'm not gonna be blown. What is the story of this show? Like, what is the setup of this story? If I understood this correctly, the setup of that story is that Law of Surprise, is it named like that?
Yeah.
And
yeah,
he gets special connection with that child through this law by full accident. And the full show is almost based on that.
I know you. I swear, man. If you frame it like that, you can make even cool story sound retarded.
But that's not cool. How? What is the cool angle to that?
I'm not saying that this is some cool or original concept, but you know, it's just first season introduction, man.
That was terrible introduction, in my opinion. Then.
I know. I I will not say that it's some great plot or great storyline, but you know, I will not say that it's some terrible. It's, you know, just first season. You are getting to know, in my opinion, what is more important for first season is, I think that is the most important thing, and they did it right, is getting your characters right. And I really think that they nailed that part.
No, I disagree completely.
You disagree?
I think they did characters okay, but I don't think that's important. I don't think that's more.
They fucking nailed Geralt.
Yeah, but if story is not hooking me, I don't care if they nail every single cast member.
I wanna fight you.
Come on, change my mind.
No, man, but I mean physically, man. I wanna beat you. No, but you know, I really listen. When I say, you know, great, I'm judging it on a fantasy like scale. I'm not saying this is like, I don't know, Battlestar Galactica or Always Sunny in Philadelphia or that level of greatness. But it's, in my opinion, very good adaptation of a book so far that I read. Because these books that I'm reading, man, they are the same as TV shows. So if you don't like TV show, you would probably don't like books too, man.
Well, if that's the case, they are not.
In my opinion, they are very good adaptation. And, you know, in my opinion, I'm reading book and, you know, they are not Malazan. They are not even, in my opinion, Stormlight.
Not even close.
But, you know, they are...
Not same stratosphere.
They are... You know what's also a thing, man? People say this, and I think that they are right. That true, like, Witcher saga doesn't start, I think, until the book 3. And that will be maybe middle of second season in TV show. Because like I said to you, I read first book and I'm now on second book. And man, these are just like, just imagine, this is collection of short stories about Witcher. They don't have anything like, they have characters in common, but they don't have some like bigger thread around. They are just, you know, one first chapter is about Geralt doing this. The next chapter is, I don't know, 10 years later, he's doing something else. It's very disjointed, man. And this is not really like type of Wheel of Time or Stormlight or Malazan. These are just some short stories until we come to the book 3. And I think in second season, I think you will like it more, basically, what I'm saying. There will be a more cohesive story.
Well, I can only judge that. At that point, right now, I cannot. The only thing I can discuss now is this first season. I got more things that I didn't really like in the story. To me, story is basically what makes the book, show, whatever. And for example, there's another thing that I really, really dislike. I don't know if you noticed this. That moment when...
What?
It was the scene with the queen and with that hedge knight. I think his name was Danny.
Yes. Yes.
And so the queen is about to kill him. And it's a very dramatic scene. And the daughter or granddaughter, I don't really know. I think it's daughter of the queen.
Daughter.
She saves him. She basically shows that she has this great power. And after she flexes her, I guess, those magical powers, everything settles down. And what do we see? The queen is coming. Oh, I accept now the law of the surprise. It's all fine now. And just the moment ago when her daughter was powerless, it was like, I'm going to kill you. Wasn't that like
man,
lamest thing ever?
I swear, man, I'm afraid when Wheel of Time comes, man, when we do reviews of Wheel of Time TV show. Oh, man, I think you will be so harsh. Oh,
man, I will be harsh if I feel... that something is not satisfactory to me. And in this case, this was such a bad scene. I hope that it's not like this in books.
I didn't come to that part in books, yes, but so far, man, they were fairly accurate. They changed some characters a little bit. You know, when I say changed, I mean they changed how they look. But they were so far very, very faithful to the events.
But you don't have any comment about this scene. Didn't you find it like that queen was such a cheesy hypocrite in one minute of the show?
Maybe that's a hypocrite character.
But she was not being presented that way. She was being...
I know. I'm now, find the coward's way out. But, I didn't bother. Thing is, man, I think me and you, we watch it kind of differently. Sometimes, man, I just want to have some fun.
Okay.
And honestly, man, this TV show, to me, I have fun watching it. I enjoy, and I really, really enjoy, man, this actor. When they choose him to play Geralt, I thought this will be some fiasco, man. This will be terrible. And this guy fucking nailed it, man. He really understood, in my opinion, this character. And not only him, also guy who played Dandelion, Jaskier.
Yeah, the bard.
He was also great. In my opinion, Yennefer was great.
I think that character is also nonsense to me. I also felt that character story arc was presented in a bad way, like bad pace. Because I remember while watching the show, like she's troubled constantly. She's very troubled. I'm sure that book presented her better. It must be. Because she was, from episode to episode, changing. Like, she was always in a bad mood, but those bad moods were, I don't know, like, just swapping. Okay, now I'm ugly, I changed to being good.
Okay, sorry.
Like, she was obsessed because she was being like this ugly thing that nobody wants. Okay, then she changed it to this beautiful woman, but now she's upset that she cannot have child. Somebody took that away from her. She paid too big of a price.
I think you are misunderstanding time scope that is happening in this first season, man. This is happening. I think this first season, actually not that I think, but it is happening over the course maybe of 30 years, maybe even more.
That's not good, in my opinion. Because we are missing too much. Is book written that way too? Like, yes. Big time, yes. Skip?
Yes. A man, in one episode, at the end he's meeting Ciri.
I know.
And in one of the episodes he's, saving Ciri's father, who didn't even marry Ciri's mother.
Yeah, I get it. I mean, I saw there were many.
There is, and that's why I'm saying to you, man. This first season is disjointed for the reason. It's how the book is, and I think and I still liked it, but in terms of story and plot, it was kind of very, very disjointed. But I think it did a good job of introducing characters and giving us the feel of the world. But, I think we already, talk too much. So, this is basically for all I have to say. I liked it. And I think it will get better.
This first season...
You are not giving thumbs down. You are saying,
I'm giving it thumbs down, in my opinion. Like, it was...
Fuck you, man. Fuck you. I give it 2 thumbs up.
Okay.
But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode. Tell us, who you agree with Duncan or me in comment section below. And see ya next week. Bye.